Hey everyone, Kev the Trainer here. In today's video, I'm going to be reviewing Apple's new on-demand fitness platform, Apple Fitness Plus. I'll start by going over its key features, share what I think is good and bad about it, and then give you my overall recommendation. Hey, if you're new here, my name is Kevin, and I'm a certified personal trainer and nutrition coach. And on my channel, you'll find weekly reviews, tips and tutorials on fitness apps, equipment, and more. So you're here today because you want to learn more about Apple Fitness Plus. Well, I've got you covered. I explored the app and took most of the classes, with the exception of those that required a treadmill and a rower, because I don't have those available. But based on what I experienced, I feel like I could give you a good sense of what to expect should you start using this app. Probably the most important feature of this platform is the ability for a user to choose from a wide range of classes. So let's start there. Class types. Apple Fitness Plus classes include 10 categories. Here's a quick breakdown. HIIT classes, short for high intensity interval training, are meant to increase and decrease your heart rate in rapid intervals, which can help the workout feel exciting and allow you to burn a lot of calories in a short amount of time. Dance classes give you a cardio workout that gets you in tune with music, and the goal is to be free and change up your normal workout routine. Clearly, I have no idea how to dance, but that's not stopping me. Strength classes serve the purpose of increasing your muscle mass, improving bone density, and helping your joints become more flexible. You can count on using weights for these classes. Yoga classes allow you to enhance your body, mind, and spirituality, making you more aware of your movements, while also improving your strength, balance, and flexibility. Core classes don't just aim to get you a six-pack, but they also help you improve your balance and flexibility, making it easier to perform a wide range of exercises and movements. Treadmill walk, treadmill run, cycling, and rowing classes share the same goal of burning calories through cardio, yet they each differ in how they accomplish that goal. Mindful cooldown classes serve as a great way to stretch and recover after a good workout. You can do a lot of these classes with just your body weight. However, some classes do require certain pieces of equipment. Compatible devices. To get started on Apple Fitness Plus, you're gonna need an Apple Watch Series 3 or later. It also needs to have watchOS 7.2 or later. After setup though, you interestingly have the ability to work out without the Apple Watch. But where's the fun in that? In order to access Apple Fitness Plus, you're going to need an Apple product such as an iPhone, iPad, or Apple TV. If you own an Apple Watch, it's pretty likely you already own an iPhone. The iPhone though, needs to be a 6S or above, with iOS 14.3 or later. If you want to use an iPad, it needs to be an iPad Pro, iPad 5th generation or later, iPad mini 4 or later, or an iPad Air 2 or later. There are so many iPads, all with iPad OS 14.3 or later. In order to use Apple Fitness Plus on an Apple TV, you need to have an Apple TV HD or an Apple TV 4K with tvOS 14.3 or higher. Also, just an FYI, there's no way to access Apple Fitness Plus from a computer using a web browser or a dedicated app, even from an iMac or a MacBook. The app. So navigating the Apple Fitness Plus app is pretty intuitive. But if you want to see a detailed walkthrough and guide on how to set everything up, I'll have a playlist right over here so you can see what it's like to explore the app on different devices like an Apple TV or an iPhone. Some highlights about the app interface though, you'll be able to navigate your way to different classes based on the categories. And from there, you can filter by trainer, time, and music. As the app starts to get to know your workout behaviors and preferences, it'll start recommending classes to you, similar to how many music and TV streaming platforms do. I think it's important to point out that right now, none of the workout classes are live. These classes are pre-recorded and are released on a weekly basis. However, there's already a wide range of content currently available. The workout. Once you find a class you want to take, go ahead and select it. You'll be prompted to hit start, and your Apple Watch will automatically track the workout. For a majority of the classes, you'll have three trainers. There's the main trainer hosting the class in the center, and two additional trainers behind them, whose purpose being there is to show what some beginner or expert level modifications are for the main trainer's exercises. Some workouts will only have one trainer present, such as the mindful cooldown. The purpose of the additional trainers is to make it so anyone from any fitness level can find a class and participate. During the workout, your Apple Watch activity metrics are broadcast on the screen. You'll see biometric data like your heart rate and active calories burned, as well as how much time you've been working out. On certain workouts, such as HIIT, cycling, rowing, and on the treadmill, you'll see a pink meter that's called a burn bar. The burn bar is basically a way to compare your performance to other people who have taken the class, only it doesn't display any specific information. It's only based on how many calories were being burned in a certain class, Those who burn more calories set the bar for the right end of the spectrum, whereas those who burn less calories are on the left end. The icon represents where you fall on that spectrum. On the right-hand side of the screen, you'll see your activity rings, and they'll also update in real time. Once you crush an activity ring, a cool animation appears, which is very encouraging. There's also music that accompanies the workout, and if you have an Apple Music subscription, you can download that playlist to your Apple Music account and listen to it at your leisure. Post-workout metrics. After you finish your workout, your post-workout metrics will appear on screen. The specific metrics you see will depend on the workouts you choose, but you can expect to find the total time you spent working out, your calories burned, average heart rate, activity rings, and your place on the burn bar if available. With the exception of yoga and mindful cooldown classes, you'll also be prompted to take a mindful cooldown at the end of your class. Your post-workout data also appears on your Apple Watch, as well as your iPhone. So how much does this all-encompassing fitness platform cost? Pricing. In terms of pricing at launch, Apple Fitness Plus costs $9.99 a month, or $79.99 a year. If you have the Apple One Premier Bundle, which includes Apple Music, Apple TV Plus, Apple Arcade, Apple News Plus, and 2 terabytes of iCloud space for $29.99 a month, you'll also get access to Apple Fitness Plus. At the time of this video in December 2020, you can actually get Apple Fitness Plus for free for 3 months with the purchase of an Apple Watch Series 3 or later. Now that I've gone over what to expect from the app, let me share my own personal thoughts about it. But before I do, if you're getting value out of this video, be sure to smash the like button and hit subscribe for more fitness app content like this. Also, let me know in the comments, are you excited about using Apple Fitness Plus? I'd love to hear. The good. So after using Apple Fitness Plus, I can say that it's a really fun workout app. I really like the integration with Apple Watch because it really puts your personal effort front and center, being able to see your heart rate and your active calories burned on the big screen. It's also encouraging to see your activity rings close in real time. So the integration with the Apple Watch is something I enjoy. I also like the way the classes are set up. I think it's very considerate that they have different trainers there to demonstrate different ways to perform the exercises for those who are beginners and for those who are experts. I think it's a really nice touch and shows that they're considerate of all fitness levels and want everyone to participate. The trainers are all very encouraging and knowledgeable about the human body, pointing out how every movement should feel and what each exercise does. So I think Apple did an excellent job in choosing their trainers. The app interface is very intuitive and easy to navigate, so you shouldn't have a big problem finding a class that you want, especially with its simplistic filtering features. The price is pretty affordable too, if you already have an Apple Watch, at $9.99 a month. That's less than the price of a typical gym membership, and you have access to a wide range of trainers and classes. However, as great as the fitness app is, it still has its drawbacks. The bad. I think an area the fitness app is lacking is in its social features. And I know that this may not matter to some people, but I know it makes a huge impact for those who do like it, because it helps them stay committed. So the social aspect is really beneficial for some. The closest social component in Apple Fitness Plus is the burn bar, and that in itself doesn't really give a lot of information, other than these were the amount of calories that were burned in the class. This also goes into the notion that there aren't any live classes on the platform just yet. All the classes are currently pre-recorded, so there's no direct connection between the user and the trainer. So I'd love to see more social features in the future. Something else I don't like about the app is its inability to broadcast on anything other than an Apple TV, iPad, or iPhone. For someone who doesn't have an Apple TV, they're kind of stuck using their iPhone or an iPad to watch the workouts. You can't even go on a computer to access Apple Fitness Plus, so you're really limited on the platforms you can actually view the workouts. I've also read that on some smart TVs that have AirPlay, which is a feature that allows you to mirror your iPhone to the TV, a lot of people had trouble mirroring Apple Fitness Plus to their TV. I just wish Apple made it easier for more people. Conclusion. Overall, I'd have to say if you're looking for a way to work out and you're a loyal Apple customer who already owns an Apple Watch and an Apple TV, this is a great way to work out. The trainers keep the class interesting and you get a good workout in, and they make it so all fitness levels can participate. And with the different options available, you can find a workout that you like. It's also really cool to see all of your activity stats on the screen. So if you find yourself constantly trying to close your activity rings on a daily basis, this is another fun way to do that. However, if you don't own an Apple Watch or an Apple TV, and you still want to do on-demand workouts, then you might want to consider the Peloton app. For $12.99 a month, you get a similar program. You can access it on the web and various smart TVs and streaming tools. It also has social features and live classes, which is something I think is a great benefit. And if you want to see my review on the Peloton app, go ahead and check out this video right over here. Wrapping this up on a good note for Apple though, I think the app and the trainers are excellent. And anyone looking for a good workout will definitely have a wide variety to choose from with Apple Fitness Plus. It'll certainly make Apple product owners very happy. While there are areas the app can improve, it's important to know that it just got released. So there's definitely gonna be more and more features added as time goes on. With that said, let me know what you think in the comments below. Be sure to like and subscribe for more content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.